Adobe's removing the 3D features from Photoshop. In this video, I'm going to tell you why and what you can do about it if you want to continue to use them. Hey Cafe crew, Colin Smith here from photoshopcafe.com. Let's talk about 3D inside of Photoshop. So Photoshop Extended, back in CS6, they added Extended, which gave us 3D video and the ability to work with medical imaging. So recently, if you've launched Photoshop, so if you go up and you change your workspace to the 3D workspace, you're gonna get this message.
Photoshop's 3D features are being discontinued. Many 3D features are not working properly. Click the more details link.
So if you want to read Adobe's official stance and everything, click on the OK button. But let me summarize it for you. So Adobe's 3D is built on OpenGL. So a few years ago, GPUs became very popular in computers, and there was an API that was used which was cross-platform. That means that what works on Windows, works on Mac, and it was OpenGL. But over the years, the different platforms have started to develop their own, DirectX with Windows, and of course, Metal on Mac. Because of this, a lot of OpenGL things are being retired, not being updated, and now they're not working anymore. So Adobe's faced with two options. One, update all the 3D features to work with DirectX on Windows, or to work with Metal on Mac, or just yank them out and have these barely functioning features gone. So what's going to happen to your 3D Photoshop files? Well, the good news is, in the future, the versions of Photoshop that are not going to have 3D, you're still able to open your files that have 3D content. What it's going to do is it's just going to rasterize the appearance of it. Unless you actually go in and rasterize that layer, it's going to remain a 3D object, but you're not going to be able to manipulate it or scale it or change it or anything like that. You can just treat it as a regular layer. And as long as you don't rasterize that, if you open it in an earlier version of Photoshop, you're still going to have access to that 3D object. It's still going to work. Now, they're going to remove the ability to import or export 3D. They're going to remove the ability, you know, obviously all the 3D tools that we have there will be gone. The spherical 360 will be gone. The ability to do 3D printing will be gone. And sadly, they're also removing the lighting effects. Now, the sad thing about that for me is lighting effects was not originally GPU dependent. It was actually built as a separate plugin, which has been in Photoshop for many, many years. Then when things started moving to the GPU, they built a new version of it. I don't know if you guys remember, they did a 16-bit version of it, and it sort of worked for a while, and then it stopped working. They dropped it to an 8-bit version, and a lot of you probably are very well aware that, you know, it's very, very buggy because I've done some tutorials on it, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. This is the problem that Adobe's having. What I really wish Adobe would do is go back and find the old version of that plugin before they completely rebuilt it to work on OpenGL and just put that back in there, guys. Throw us a bone, please let us have that, and then we could just go ahead and keep using it like we have for many years. But for now, all of those features are going to be removed from Photoshop. So that gives you two choices. One, to continue to work with 3D inside of Photoshop, or two, do something else. I'm going to answer both of those issues for you right now. Number one, if you want to continue to work with 3D inside of Photoshop, this is what you want to do. If you look under Photoshop, you'll see About Photoshop. We see we're in version 22.5. Now, what you want to do is go up under Preferences, and then under Preferences, we're going to go down to Technology Previews. Under Technology Previews, you have the ability to deactivate Native Canvas. Now, if you're going to be working a lot of 3D, this is a great option. We go up under the Creative Cloud. Then what you want to do is go to where it says Photoshop. And as you can see here, I've got an earlier version of Photoshop running. You can see there's 22.5. But you can go and choose this little ellipsis, and you can look for other versions. So this is going to give you other versions of Photoshop. So what I would recommend you do right now, if you want to continue to use it, is go in and install a 21 point anything. A 21.2 would work, and notice I've got it installed. The reason I have this is because I can run two versions of Photoshop. So that's 2021, and look at this, Photoshop 2020 is also running. So you can run them both at the same time. So use Photoshop 2020 for 3D for now. Now I say for now, So around about the time of Max is when they do the full release, which would be Photoshop 2022, maybe they're going to call it. We don't know. But it's going to be the next version. So it's going to be 23. So that means you can run 23 and 22 simultaneously. So when that time happens, install the 22.0, use that for your 3D, and just keep it forever. Now, Adobe says they're going to support this for up to 2 years. So I'm not sure if that means there's going to be updates or anything like that in there. But what I'm doing right now is running version 21. Okay, so what is the other option if you don't want to run two versions of Photoshop? Okay, so if you go into Creative Cloud here, one of the things you'll notice when we choose, you know, graphic design or anything like that, you might notice that I have Dimension here because it's installed, but you might notice that Dimension has been removed. And this is because Adobe is moving all their 3D, if we click on the 3D tab here, to Substance. So Dimension is now Substance Stager, which is where we can put together 3D elements, render them, 3D Painter. So Substance is a company that Adobe acquired a while ago. And actually, it does very, very good for texture mapping and different things like that, for creating textures. So this is what Substance 3D Painter is used for that. We've got Sampler Designer. They're building a suite of products for 3D. Now, the downside of that is that it doesn't come with your Creative Cloud. So if you're not a huge, heavy 3D user, don't get rid of Dimension. If you have Dimension here, don't uninstall it because you might never be able to install it again. And if you want to use the newer updated version of Substance, you're going to have to try it or buy it. And this is how much it is. The Substance Collection is essentially $50 a month. Right now, it's $40 a month. So to summarize, if you want to continue to do 3D, just make sure you have an older version of Photoshop installed. But just remember, the writing is on the wall. At some point, they're pushing this into Substance, which is going to be a separate subscription. But now for people that are using 3D professionally, there's a lot of good things there in Substance, and it's worth checking out. Just really depends who you are and what you're doing, whether or not you want to continue on this path. So I hope this video has helped you understand why they're retiring 3D and also what you need to do to continue using 3D in Photoshop. So anyway, let me know your thoughts in the comments underneath. Hopefully that was helpful. And if you guys like this, hit that subscribe button. Turn on notifications and you won't miss any of my videos. So anyway, guys, do me a favor. Hit that thumbs up, that like button. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. Look for more tutorials from me. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.